Hey guys, so today I'm going to be reading you the seventh story of fairy tales and rhymes. This story is called Twinkle the Tooth Fairy. Twinkle the Tooth Fairy was always very busy. Every night she collected the milk teeth that the children left under their pillows, but the teeth were so tiny they were difficult to find in the dark. Late one summer's evening, Twinkle was looking for the last milk tooth of the night. Finally, she found it and put her last shiny coin under the pillow. "Good night," whispered Twinkle as she gently kissed the sleeping child and flew silently out of the window. The sun was just coming up as Twinkle flew back to Fairyland. All the fairies in Fairyland were very busy getting ready for the fairy ball. Fairy food had to be made by the best fairy cooks. Hundreds of fairy lights had to be put up, and the fairy orchestra was practicing very hard. Before going to bed, Twinkle decided to go and see her friend Thimble, the fairy dressmaker. Thimble had been busy too, making all the dresses for the fairy ball. "What beautiful dresses!" exclaimed Twinkle. "I'm glad you like them," said Thimble, "but they would be so much better if I could decorate them with golden thread. I can't find any in the whole of Fairyland. I know there's lots of golden thread. Leave it to me," Twinkle said excitedly, and she flew off high into the sky. Soon she was among hundreds of bright shining stars, and she flew until she reached a huge golden ball. "The sun, please, Mr. Sun," she asked, "can you spare me some of your fine golden thread for my friend Thimble?" Twinkle waited. All of a sudden, a long trail of golden thread came slowly from the center of the sun. Twinkle took the end of it and began to pull it towards her. "That tickles," laughed the sun. Twinkle had soon gathered a large bundle of precious thread. "Thank you, Mr. Sun," she said. "You're very welcome, Twinkle," chuckled the sun. When Thimble saw what Twinkle had bought her, she clapped her hands with joy. "Thank you, Twinkle," she said. "Now my dresses will be perfect, and I promise you will have the finest dress of all for the ball." "I've never been to the fairy ball," said Twinkle quietly. "Why ever not?" asked Thimble curiously. "It takes me such a long time to find all of the children's teeth. I never get back in time," Twinkle said sadly. "Don't you worry, I'll think of something," said Thimble. Twinkle felt very tired after a busy night and went straight to bed. When she woke up the next day, she was surprised to see a large bag at the foot of her bed. Inside the bag were the most beautiful purple and gold velvet purses pinned to a bag and a note which read, "Dear Twinkle, I have made you these special purses from the leftover fairy dress cloth. The children can put their teeth into them. The purses will be very much easier for you to find in the dark. With a bit of luck, you will be back in time for the ball. Your best fairy friend, Thimble." Later that evening, Twinkle collected all the children's milk teeth as usual. She left each child with a shiny coin tucked into one of the purses, which she carefully placed under their pillows. Twinkle whispered to each sleeping child, "Please use the purse to keep your next milk tooth safe." A few days later, it was the night of the fairy ball. Twinkle was very excited. She sure hoped that she'd be back in town to join in the fun. But first, she had an important job to do. When she flew off that night to collect the milk teeth, Twinkle was overjoyed to see that each child had put the milk tooth inside their purse. Now they were easy to find. She kissed each child and whispered, "Thank you." After gathering all the teeth up carefully, Twinkle flew quickly back to Fairyland. When she was nearly home, she could hear sounds of the fairy orchestra in the distance. The whole sky was lit up with the lights of the fairy boat. "It's already started," she thought, flying even faster. When she reached home, Twinkle rushed to see Dimble. "Am I too late?" she asked breathlessly. "It's only just begun," laughed Dimble. Twinkle had a wonderful time at the fairy ball, and everyone agreed that in her beautiful new dress, she was the prettiest fairy of all.